This morning, I just want to share with you a story. And hopefully the story will help us to be the church that Jesus wants us to be. Now, I entitled the message this morning as I was preparing, A Good House Cleaning. This is exactly what Jesus was doing in Jerusalem when he went into the temple. The faith was stained. People were not doing what they were supposed to do. Congregations were failing. There was always sadness. People were not interested in serving. There was no interest in religion. And as they were preparing for Passover, this is when Jesus went to the temple to cleanse it, to get rid of stuff. This is what Lent is all about. We need to get rid of stuff. Stuff that makes it impossible for us to function fully as children of God. As a church, we need to get rid of stuff that causes turmoil and frustration. We need to clean the house so that the Spirit of Christ can dwell in this place. Now, as I was preparing this message, a nephew of mine sent me a story that really touched me deeply, and I want to share this story with you. And maybe from this story, we can learn something. This is the story about a girl called Fatima. And Fatima went to a school in a neighboring village where she wasn't known well. For 3 weeks, she came to school late, and every time the teacher punished her. On the fourth week, Fatima didn't attend school at all, and many thought she had given up on school due to everyday punishment. However, Fatima reported again on fifth week, and this time she came earlier than everybody. When the teacher came to class, Fatima was punished for not attending school the previous week. But the teacher was also kind enough to commend her for coming early that day, stating that the punishment had finally yielded some results. Just then, Fatima asked if she could say something. And the teacher gave her permission. And this is what Fatima told the class and the teacher. I have been raised by a single mother without a brother or a sister. 5 weeks ago, my mother fell ill and was hospitalized. I came late. I had to prepare something for her every morning and pass by the hospital to deliver the same. Unfortunately, Mother passed away last week. And that's the reason I didn't come to school. We buried her on Friday. Today, I came early. Since I didn't have to prepare anything or even pass by the hospital. And now that she's gone, I will always be here early. As she sat down, no one in the whole class was able to hold their tears. The teacher was not spared. Friends, how many times do we judge others for things we know not? This is the question that Jesus is asking us this morning as he encourages us to clean house. How many times do we judge people? How many times do we look at faces of people and decide that this person is good or bad? Just think about it a moment. These are some of the things that we need to clean. This is what Jesus is asking us to clean. Judging people. And also putting people in categories. We've chosen an anthem, a Lenten theme, be kind to one another. This morning, I want to encourage the church. Be kind, always, and put yourself in other people's shoes, just like Christ did, putting himself for us. Be kind to one another. I just want to encourage you. As Strathroy United Church, we need to be kind to one another, and we need to move forward and begin to respect and embrace one another with the love that is so deep. You see, if we love one another with the love that is deep, we are not able to divide us into small little groups. Because we love one another so deep. And I love this church so deep. I know my time is up. I don't have much time. But one thing I can tell this church, I love the people here with all my heart. And I don't categorize people as good or bad. I categorize people as human beings making mistakes. So I want to encourage you, we need to cleanse. We need to move forward as Strathroy United Church and show the world and show Strathroy community that we can love one another. This is why I said it amazes me. I saw it at the fall supper. I saw how this church worked together in peace and harmony, how we did things together. I saw it many times, and I saw it on Friday again, that we make a difference. So, Strathroy United Church, Jesus Christ is asking us to clean house. To break the barriers that keeps us from being united and working together. We have history. Don't just be wrong, we have history in this church of division. We have history of not working together sometimes. And that history sometimes still continues. We still have people who see themselves different from others. But I'm pleading with you this morning, as we prepare for Resurrection Day, as we prepare for Easter, as we prepare for the good things, that we need to get rid of some of the stuff that doesn't help this church move forward. Let me end. I don't want to take your time. Be kind. Always. And put yourself in another person's shoes. This is what I studied. You put yourself in another person's shoes so that you can feel the pain that this person is feeling, that you can feel the hurt that this person is feeling. You put yourself in their shoes. So this Lenten Sunday, as God and Jesus is cleaning house, a good, good house cleaning. Let's go home. Think about the things. Think about the things that we do that stops this church from going forward. Be kind to one another, please.